live in this world or pass away or die, they leave their knowledge behind. The only knowledge we leave behind is either you write it down, or you speak it out, or you share it, or you talk about it. Otherwise, you die with your mouth. You die with your mouth. Just like Steve Jobs took his knowledge with him. We all take it with us. So my mission is to share the opportunity of the knowledge I have. From back home, from all the countries I've traveled to, in addition to what I've gained here, to give it to those who are willing or who have ears to listen or who are willing to hear what I have to say or the advice I have. And I know, at least, there's nothing in this world you can learn and knowledge. So regardless, so my idea is to give it away most of the time. You go and get something, but most of the time they don't teach you how to do it after you get it or after it's done. How do you practice it at home? Or how do you take care of it at home or by yourself? And that's the knowledge I'm really willing to share. It's not just me being a stylist or skincare specialist.
It's not just you going to do it.
It's not just me talking about hair or skin. But either way, we have to talk in general about human, the structure of the being. Because that's the only thing that you take with you, you live with you, you walk with you, you die with you. So, as I was talking before, we all do make mistakes. And the mistakes sometimes catch up with us as we're growing. The same thing as we were talking about eating habit. If you can see, every human being who was brought up in their life with a food or a taste of a flavor, eat, that will stick to their mouth.
They were repeating.
I said, when you were born, whatever you were brought up with, whether it's sugar, whether it's a drink, whether it's a habit of eating this, you get stuck with it. And normally the tongue, which oppresses us, doesn't let it go. You always pray for it. And craving for it becomes a habit. And until then, something happens and say, hey, this habit you have is going to kill you or is eating you up, so stop it. You normally don't take care of it until something big happens, like sickness or cancer or something happening. So, oh, I'm going to change it and eat good. But hey, we are all used to that. We grow, that's why we grow, to learn what is right and wrong. So my point in life is, regardless of what I'm ready to teach, whether it's on hair or skin, I still tell people, I say, how do you grow? You grow by sleeping, sucking things inside you, and you grow. Every part of the skin has a hair follicle, and whatever you put in, suck into your system, just by the same way you eat anything, suck into you to generate whether good health or bad health for us. So my point in life is to teach. But most of the time we don't see our inside, we see the outside, and that's my even purpose of teaching. I'm teaching the outside more than the inside. But when the thing happens and pops out and your skin started getting some discoloration and skin problems or hair started breaking out, then you say, hey, something is wrong with me. But then we forget what we've eaten inside us before. And all plays a part. All this plays a part in our human life and human